present Jimmy Clitheroe as the Clitheroe Kid with Peter Sinclair, Patricia Burke, Danny Ross, and Diana Day in...
Playing with Fire.
Right, Mother. That's the washing up done and the room tidied. Hadn't we better start getting ready to go out?
In a moment, Susan. I'm going to sit down for a minute.
But you said you wanted to be at the shops for two, and I've still got to comb your hair out.
Well, it'll have to wait. Oh, I hate Saturdays. It's all go. Where's that chair? Oh, that's better.
Would you like a cigarette, Mother?
Oh, thanks, love. Just 5 minutes, peace and quiet.
Hop the reserves! Oh. Come on, the black and tans!
Oh, no.
Hi, Mum. Hey, look, this is the new football rattle my granddad bought me. Isn't it a smasher?
Yes. Yes, it's very nice.
Hey, but you're not looking. Look, see, look,
yeah,
see.
I am looking.
Well, look, see, look, see. Oh. I've burnt me initials on it with a poker. Come on, Crawford, fire one in. Look out, Crawford. Here comes their fullback. Don't go round him. Slip the ball through his bandy legs.
Will you shut up?
What's up with you, scraggy neck?
Mother's trying to have 5 minutes peace and quiet.
Well, I'm not stopping her. Hey, Mum, what a game it'll be this afternoon. The reserves are trying out two players they've bought. The Barker and Middleton. Barker's the new goalkeeper. He's taking the place of Rip Van Wilkins.
Oh,
old Charlie Wilkins, the second team goalkeeper. The one who keeps his pension book under his cap.
Don't talk silly.
Well, he's past it and he's daft. He's so daft that next to him, your boyfriend, Alfie Hall's Dr. Bronowski.
You and your jokes. I'll go and have a wash, Mother, before I do your hair.
Right, Ola.
Oh, dear. Now you sound tired, Mum. What you want is 5 minutes peace and quiet.
Yes, chance will be a fine thing. Oh, I wish your granddad would hurry back and take you to that match.
Why, where's he gone?
Oh, Mr. Higginbottom called and then went out for a quick one to the Rose and Crown.
Well, he mustn't be late back. The kickoff's 2:30. I'll look through the window to see if anybody's carrying him back home.
Yes, you do that.
Oh, there's somebody coming up the path, Mum. Does Grandad have a bald head and a dog collar?
What are you talking about?
Well, if he doesn't, the vicar's calling.
Oh, the vicar. The vicar? And here's me half dressed with my curlers in.
Oh, well, stop where you are. He's seen you undressed in your curlers before.
What?
You remember when you were in hospital.
Oh, don't be silly. Keep him talking while I go upstairs and make myself presentable.
Right, Mum. I wonder what the vicar wants. He probably wants to ask Grandad if he's lost a button off his shirt. Because he found it in his collecting plate. Hello, Vicar.
Oh, young Master James, isn't it, eh?
Yes, it is, eh? Are you coming in?
Oh, thank you. Yes, thank you. Is your mother in?
Yes, sir, she'll be down in a minute. Would you come in the living room, eh?
Yes, thank you. Well, James, and how are things at school?
Shocking. How are things in church? Still working that one day a week?
You must come and find out for yourself sometime, eh? You know, James, you don't come very often to church, especially for evensong.
Well, don't blame me. Blame the BBC. They've got the Billy Cotton Band show on at the same time as your sermon.
Verily, this little sheep is going to take some getting back into the fold. Ah, did I hear the front door just then?
Oh, it'll be me granddad back from the pub. The public library. Oh.
Come on in, Higgy. Oh, that was a smashing joke about the parson and the turkey's bath. You see,
You see, the barmaid told it to you.
Ah, that's right. When you nipped out for the paper. She tells some good uns, that young filly.
She does that. Now, I'll just get that flask of whiskey for the match.
Hello, Grandad. Did you manage to change your library books?
Oh, hello, Jim. Here's some crisps for you from the Rose and Crown. I've got a joke to tell you about a parson. You see, he was getting undressed.
Grandad,
and
the vicar's here.
Aye, well, you see here. Oh, hello, vicar. I didn't realize you were here.
Good afternoon, Mr. Sinclair. I've been looking on the wine when it was red.
No, he drinks brown ale.
Quiet.
Hey, Pete, don't keep me standing about here like a spare dinner. Where's that flask of booze for the football match?
You remember the vicar?
Aye. He went to the baths and... good afternoon, you reverend.
Oh, yes, it's Mr. Higginbottom, of course, yes. I married you, didn't I? Yes.
No, he married Mrs. Higginbottom, didn't he?
Shut up.
Vicar, what a pleasant surprise. How long have you been here?
Ever since you dashed upstairs so he wouldn't see you in your curlers.
That'll do.
Well, what can we do for you, Vicar?
Well, now, I've called about the flask of whiskey. Oh, no, no. No. The raffle tickets, yes, for the church jumble sale this afternoon.
Raffle tickets? Oh, heck.
You said you'd get them printed and have them delivered to me, Mrs. Clitheroe. Hmm?
Yes, that's right. I told Jimmy to collect them yesterday and let you have them. Did you collect those tickets?
Well, no.
You're a naughty boy. I told you those tickets had to go round to the vicarage last night. I even sent you off to the printer specially to get them.
Yes, I know, ma'am, but the printers were closed when I got there. It was after six.
You went to the fairground with my Aussie at 5:30.
Oh, did I? I don't remember that.
Well, you should do. You sent Aussie to get a ball back on the coconut shies. And he came home with a lump on his head.
That does it, Father. Jimmy does not go to that football match this afternoon.
Oh, but it's the two new players this afternoon.
Well, you won't see them. You'll collect those raffle tickets, take them to the church hall and come straight back here. And no football match for you.
Oh, but, ma'am...
Don't argue. You deliberately disobeyed me, so this is your punishment.
But I was looking forward to the match. It's not fair. It's not blooming well fair.
My punishment is greater than I can bear. Genesis chapter 4.
It's a rotten dead liberty. James Bond, chapter 9. Fancy you calling round.
You see, I wouldn't have called round, because Susan said not to call round till 5. So that's why I've called round now instead of 5, to tell her I won't call round till 6, because I won't be back to call at 5. Something's missing.
Yes, your brains.
That big flower vase you always have on your table, it's gone.
Yes. Mum and Susan took it to sell at the vicar's blinking jumble sale.
Oh, is that where she's gone? Yeah, I like going to jumble sales. I picked up some very funny bits of junk at jumble sales.
Oh, so you first met our Susan at a jumble sale.
Now, look, you, there's nobody in to stop me thumping you, so watch it.
Sorry, Alfie. I was fed up. You see, I was going to watch the reserves down at the stadium.
Oh, I remember you telling me. You were going with your granddad and old Iggy. Have they gone without you?
Yeah, they'd left me on my own with only the goldfish and you to talk to. And from here, I can't tell the difference.
Hey, well, look, if you're going to be rude, I'll just get on my bike and go to the match. It'll take me half an hour to get there as it is.
But the stadium's only 5 minutes away. Are you riding there on your bike or carrying it?
I'm not talking about the reserves. I mean the first team. They're playing away at Oldham.
Yes, well, I could go to Oldham, because all they said was I hadn't to go and watch the reserves at the stadium.
Well, that's why I called to tell Susan it might be 6 before I get back. Who said?
Said what?
You want to go and watch the reserves.
Oh, My pals, they said, don't go and watch the reserves. I think they meant it'll be a rotten game. Of course, there's still the tickets to collect.
What are you going on about?
Alfie, I've got a treat for you. I'm taking you to watch the first team at Oldham on your bike.
Thank you very much.
But on the way, we'll just call to see the vicar.
What do we want to see the vicar for?
One day you want him to marry you and our Susan, and he'll be very good at helping you with your problems.
Ah, when I marry Susan, I won't have any problems.
You will, you know. He'll have me for a brother-in-law. Want it a smashing game, Alfie?
What, I can't hear you.
A smashing game. The first team at Oldham. It was a smashing game.
Look, let me concentrate when I'm driving. Hey, Jimmy.
What?
Wasn't it a smashing game?
That's what I just said.
The traffic lights are red, I never saw them.
Not the traffic lights. Look, I'm trying to... Alfie, pull up, quick, pull up.
You are?
I said pull up.
I can't hear you. Oh, hang on, I'll pull up. Now, what is it?
I was shouting for you to pull up, it's urgent.
Oh, not again, you shouldn't have had all that lemonade.
It's not that. Luke, that toy shop over the road. There's smoke coming from under the door. And look, the shop's closed. I bet there's nobody in.
Oh, there's a fire and nobody about it. Jimmy, what are we going to do?
Come on with me to that phone box.
All right. Oh, you know, Jimmy, there isn't all that much smoke.
Well, perhaps we've spotted it before it really got going. Here we are. Here's the phone box.
Right, Jimmy. I'd better phone the fire brigade. After all, I'm a grown-up.
Well, hurry up and ring them.
Yeah, but I'll just read the instructions on the wall here so I know the proper thing to do. Minute now, what does it say? Try Webster's taxis for your next funeral.
The next funeral round here will be yours. Dial 999.
All right, come on, here we go.
You daft apeth, you've dialed sixes. Do you want all the firemen to come round walking on their hands here, Alfie?
Yeah, go on then, all right.
Oh, come on, hurry up. If I don't get home before six, there'll be another fire. On my sit-upon. Hello? It's a fire, miss. Yes. Hello? Yes, a fire. It's a toy shop called Carter's. The street? It's the main road from Oldham. Yeah, that's right. Carter's Toy Shop. There's smoke coming from under the door.
Well, thank you very much for your prompt help.
Oh, it was nothing, Mr. Fireman. We only did as duty, didn't we, Alfie?
Yes, that's right.
Oh, well, sonny, you two did a good job. Except for your friend here when he kept treading on the hose pipe.
Yeah, now you know why I kept wanting to borrow your fireman's axe.
Yeah, I see your point. Still, it was fortunate you spotting that fire. It'll all go on my report, you know. You were just passing, you said.
Yes, on my back. You see, we were on our way back from the match. Blow me leg!
Look, mister, we'll have to be going now. We're in a hurry.
Oh, hang on a minute. You know, Mr. Carter, who owns that shop, will be very pleased with you when he gets back. He'll want to know who you are.
Oh, will he? Well, I'm called Alfie. Be ankle!
Come on, Alfie, let's hop off.
No, wait a minute. I must have your name.
No, it's all right, mister. Just say we were a couple of unknown heroes and leave it at that. Come on, Alfie, back to your bike.
Oh, all right, then.
Ta-ra, Mr. Fireman. See you next bonfire night.
No. Wait a minute. Your name, I want your name. Oh, all right, lads, I'm coming.
Oh, thank goodness we got away from him.
Well, look, why didn't you tell him what his names were?
Because if I had done, your name would have been Mud.
What do you mean?
He might have put his names in the paper and it would have all come out. How you took me to the football match at Oldham when I wasn't supposed to go.
Oh, you what? You mean you weren't supposed to go? I shouldn't have taken you?
No, so play your cards right with me and I'll see you don't get into trouble at home.
May get in trouble?
Yeah, it was your idea. You talked me into it.
Well, there's no such thing.
Oh, no. Whose back did we go on?
Well, mine.
And who paid for us to get in the ground?
Me.
And who bought me all that lemonade and that popcorn and them two hot dogs?
Well, I did.
Well, there you are then. You haven't got a leg to stand on. Daft.
Oh, it's you, Jim. I'm sorry I kept you waiting, but I've been up in the bathroom helping me dad.
To play with his boats?
Yeah. No, you daft thing. My mother said she was fed up here in the drip.
So I told you to shut up?
Yeah. Now, don't be funny. I'm talking about the tap leaking. Anyway, what have you come round to our house for?
Have you read the evening paper yet?
No, I give it to my dad first. And then my mum gets it to see what's on the telly and read the births and deaths.
To see if you're still alive.
Yes, I'm... What?
Oh, never mind. Listen, the story's in the evening paper. How I saved the toy shop from being burnt down.
Well, how did they find your name out?
My name's not in. They just call me the Modest Boy Hero. And it says they want me to come forward because the fire chief would like to send a letter to the parents of this shy young hero. That's me. But best of all, Alfie, Mr. Carter, who owns the toy shop, says he would like to give a reward to this modest young lad. That's me again.
Oh, what a pity, isn't it?
Why?
Well, you can't go to him and collect the reward because you'd have to tell him your name and then it'd be in the paper and your mum would know that you'd gone out when she told you not to.
Don't worry about that. Just get your motorbike out and come with me to see Mr. Carter at the toy shop.
But what are you going to do?
I'll just tell him I saved his shop, I want the reward, and my name is Ozzy Higginbottom. Well, Alfie, all thanks to you, we've got here after the blooming shop's closed.
Oh, well, I'm sorry, Jim.
You want to sell that motorbike and buy a pogo stick.
Bike's all right. I just got something stuck in my feet, bike.
Well, you shouldn't eat so fast.
Look, we'd still have been in time if you hadn't got me to go the wrong way up a one-way street.
Well, it was a shortcut. It could have saved 5 minutes.
It could have got me 6 months when that policeman saw me. And then you've got to be clever, haven't you? And when he said this is a one-way street, you had to say, that's all right, we're only going one way.
Well, I thought he'd laugh. Anyway, he won't do anything about it. He daren't.
Well, what do you mean he daren't?
Oh, I told him your father was Chief Inspector Barlow. Hey, Alfie, there's somebody just switched a light on in the back of the shop. Hello, anybody in? Mr. Carter, open up. I think he's coming, Alfie.
You'll have the door off.
Stop banging that door. I'm not opening it. We're closed. Shut. Locked up.
I know you're closed, but I have to see you, Mr. Carter.
Look, I close at 6 o'clock precisely on the dot to the minute. After that, I don't open for anyone. No one. Nobody. Not at all. Definitely not. No.
Hey, Alfie. He sounds the right bloke for a toy shop. I'll bet his wife winds him up every morning.
Mr. Carter, he wants to see you about the fire he had on Saturday.
Yes, I saved your shop.
What, do you mean you're the lad who called the fire brigade, phoned for help, raised the alarm?
Yes, I, me, myself, the three of us. We dial 999-999-9.
Oh, cut it out. You said in the paper you wanted to see him.
Oh, yes, I do indeed. Come in. Here, wait a minute, what's this? Motorbike, leather jacket, you're not one of them hoodlums, are you? Teddy boys, turn-ups, tear-aways.
No, he's a friend, a pal, a mug. Can we come in, Mr. Carter?
Oh, I suppose so, yes, come in.
Oh, thank you.
Ah.
Well, Mr. Carter, what reward do I get?
No, just a minute, a second, not so fast. How do I know you deserve the reward?
I've told you I'm the lad who saved your shop, the modest hero, the shy one.
Well, anyone could say that, couldn't they? I mean, I didn't see you on Saturday. I don't even know your name.
I'm Ozzy Higginbottom, aren't I, Alfie?
Yes, Jimmy. Go on, me lad.
Ozzy, Jimmy Higginbottom, Mr. Carter. Jimmy's my second name. Look, Alfie saw me phone the fire brigade, didn't you?
Well, now, son, if you are the lad, you can have a reward with pleasure, but anyone can say they saved my shop and tell me their name. Now, can you prove it?
Of course he can. Give us your cap, Jim. Look, his name's in there.
No, you're big.
Oh, it says Jimmy Clitheroe.
But that's his other name. He told you Jimmy's his second and Clitheroe's his maiden name, nickname. He had two mothers, the fathers.
I must have got the wrong cap. Look, I called the fire brigade, and the fireman thanked me afterwards and asked me who I was.
Oh, that's it, of course. Yes, he'd know. The fire officer in charge, Fire Officer Jackson. I'll ring the fire station. Phone up, speak to him.
Yes. Good.
Oh, well, I'll go on the back and phone then. Have a look round the shop to see what you might want for a reward, if you are the boy, you know.
Right, Mr. Carter. The first thing I want to find, Alfie, is a first aid outfit with splints and bandages.
Splints and bandages?
Yes, because the next time you forget I'm Ozzy Higginbottom, you'll be wearing them.
Oh, don't be funny. It was just a slip of the tongue. Anybody could have done it if they were...
Soft as you?
Soft as me. I'm warning you.
All right, let's have a look round the shop to see what I want. Do you think he'd let me have a football set?
What kind?
Well, a bowl and boots, shorts and shirts. For 11 of us. 2 goalposts and nets.
Oh, I'm sure we... Why don't you ask him to make your partner? Look, all you did was dial 999. It's a good job it wasn't a pet shop. You'd have been asking for an elephant.
No, I wouldn't. I'd have asked for a dustman bird.
A dustman bird? What's that?
It's a bit like you. Every time it opens its mouth, out comes a load of rubbish.
You're asking for a good hiding, me lad.
Well, you're lucky, Ozzy. Ozzy.
Oh, yes, me. How do you mean, Mr. Carter?
Well, Fire Officer Jackson was just finishing his shift on duty. Packing up, clocking off. So he said he'd call in on his way home and identify you.
Oh, good.
Yes, well, while we're waiting, you may as well decide on what you want. Anything up to a cost of, say, well, you know, £3.
Oh, I see. Well, come on, Alfie. While I'm looking at the sports gear, you try the cuddly toys. There's a walrus there. That's the living image of our Susan with a mustache.
You, I won't tell you again. One more funny crack and you've had it.
Oh, yes, no doubt about it, Mr. Carter. Young Ossie Higginbottom here is definitely our little hero.
Thanks, Mr. Jackson.
Good. Well, lad, I hope you didn't mind me checking up like this, but it was possible you could have been a phony, a trickster, an imposter, wasn't it?
Not unless I was triplets. Anyway, can I have them roller skates as my reward?
Of course, yes, certainly.
Don't bother to wrap them, I'll wear them now. And Alfie can pull me home behind his motorbike.
Oh, no, we can't do it like that, can we, Mr. Jackson?
Oh, no, of course not. We want your address so we can send a letter of thanks from the fire chief together with your reward from Mr. Carter.
What?
No more modesty. We want your parents to know just what you did, lad.
That's what I'm afraid of. Look, I'll tell you what. I'll take the skates now and you can send the letter to Mr. Higginbottom. Me dad. Later. The house is called Peace Haven, 24 Lavender Road, next to the gasworks.
No. I'm afraid I will have to send the roller skates. I mean, we want to do this thing properly, you know.
But, Mr. Carter...
Oh, come on, Jim. It's no use arguing.
Lou, will you... Yes, you're right, Alfie. All right, Mr. Carter. They won't be there before tomorrow, will they?
No, of course not, no.
Right, well, we'd better be going, Alfie. Come on. Well, thanks very much, Mr. Carter.
Not at all, my boy. Thank you.
And we thank you as well, son.
Oh, that's all right. Come on, Alfie, let's get round to Ozzy's. Our house, I mean.
You nearly got a kick on your ankle there, Jimmy Higginbottom. Well, you've had it. You know, Ozzy's going to be very pleased with his present.
Don't worry, I'll have them skates off him. We'll go and see him now while his dad's out.
How do you know his dad'll be out?
Because it's opening time. Mind, Ozzy might want something to keep his mouth shut apart from my fist. I think we'll have to give him a couple of bob.
Well, I think that's... What do you mean, we?
Well, you're in it as well. I wouldn't have seen the fire if you hadn't taken me to the football match. After my mum said I couldn't go. You don't want her to be cross with you, do you?
Yeah, little twist. I'm not giving Ozzie 2 shillings.
All right. Well, give him a bob each. Let's have yours.
Well, I don't mind paying half. Yeah, there's mine. Hey, now, let's see your shilling.
Well, I'm broke, so could you lend me a shilling till payday?
All right, yeah. But I want it back on payday.
Thanks.
Hey, just a minute. When is payday?
Don't ask me. You're the one who's working.
Here you are, Father. Lunch is on the table. Come on, put your paper away and eat it while it's hot.
Aye, right, my dear.
Oh, what's keeping Jimmy? Did you call him in, Susan?
3 times. He's been on those roller skates since he got up. He probably slept in them.
Oh, Father, will you call him? Tell him I'll warm his seat for him.
Help!
From the sound of that, his seat's probably burst into flames.
Oh, my goodness.
What? Oh, blooming it. Oh!
Jimmy, what have you done?
I've bent a wheel and broke me big end.
Jimmy, don't be silly. Now, come on, show me where it hurts.
Not in front of Susan and me, ma'am.
All right, Father, take him in the other room.
It's all right, ma'am, the pain's wearing off. I don't think I've broken anything, really.
From the crash, it sounded as if you'd broken the front door down.
Oh, shut up, Scraggy Annie. You wouldn't care if I broke my leg.
Oh, but I would. I'd take you to the vet myself.
All right, Susan, all right, that'll do.
That's right, ma'am, you...
And don't you call her names.
It's your own fault, Jimmy. Skating in the hall.
I wish Ozzy hadn't sold them to you.
I can't understand it. They're brand new and expensive from the look of them.
Aye. And where did you get the money?
It was only 2 bob.
2 bob?
Down. 2 bob down I gave him. Anyway, he couldn't use them. His feet are too big.
Excuse me, the front door's open. Ah, there you are, you little thief.
Mr. Higginbottom, what do you mean?
Hello, Mrs. Clitheroe. This little boy of yours.
I don't feel well again, ma'am.
What are you on about, Higgy?
Those roller skates he's got, they belong to our Ozzie.
He gave them to me for 2 bob.
I know, you little twister. The price on the box is 3 quid, and you talked Ozzie into selling them for 2 bob. Well, there's your money back. Come on, let's have them skates.
No, they're mine. You're not getting them.
Jimmy, give them to Mr. Higginbottom.
Oh, ma'am.
Do as your mother says.
You're all rotten.
What's that?
All right. I'm taking them off.
Our Ozzie got them for calling the fire engine when a shop was on fire.
He wouldn't have the brains to call for help if his trousers were on fire.
What was that?
Nothing.
Was he the boy they mentioned in the paper?
That's right. They call him the shy hero. He tried to pretend it wasn't him, even after I'd read the letter from the fire chief, but he had to admit it in the end.
Well,
that's where I'll kick him, in the end. Shy hero.
Jimmy, stop mumbling.
Here, one of these wheels is damaged.
Jimmy, give Mr. Higginbottom that money back to pay for it.
What? You mean he's getting my 2 bob and me roller skates?
Yes. You ought to be ashamed of yourself, taking advantage of Ozzie like that, after what he's done.
Don't worry, after what Ozzie's done, tomorrow I'll see he gets everything he deserves. We'll carry him shoulder high to the canal.
Those involved with the Clitheroe Kid this week were Peter Sinclair as grandfather, Patricia Burke as mother, Danny Ross as Alfie Hall, and Diana Day as Susan, with Derek Giler, John Graham, and Tony Melody. The recorded program was written by James Casey and Frank Roscoe, produced by James Casey, and starred Jimmy Clitheroe as the kid himself.
You might like to know that finally I told them that I was the real hero. After all, a boy should tell the truth, and a spanking only hurts for an hour, while roller skates last for years. So I told Grandad I'd call the fire brigade, handed him his slipper and bent over. He smacked me, and then he had the nerve to send me to bed for telling lies.